is the dream of every girl to have a fairy tale wedding like one right out of a Disney movie. Hundreds of people, lavish decorations, a handsome prince, and a budget as high as the castle they would get married in. Unfortunately for Becky Sue, all she had was Earl and a handful of cash. Becky, having won Miss El Paso 2 years in a row, had an ego the size of Texas itself, and wasn't going to let these few minor details get in the way of her perfect wedding. She was on a war path to make sure everything went exactly her way, and wasn't afraid to show it. Through the classified section of the local newspaper, she found some raggedy, underqualified group of men to set up her wedding.
The workers were underqualified. They had no insurance, and they didn't know any type of safety standards or regulations at all. They had no policies within their company, as they were self-employed and were not part of a professional event company. It's definitely important for people when planning an event to hire qualified professionals. Even though it may require a higher cost, it is definitely worth it in the end.
They called themselves the Miller Brother Entertainment Company and were known to be a little on the wild side. The irony in their name was that Miller was exactly what the boys drank on and off the job.
The main problem with drinking on the job is that it poses a threat not only to yourself, but to everyone around you. As you drink more, your blood alcohol content rises, and you start to lose your fine motor skills, your vision blurs, your judgment starts lacking, and you start losing your reflexes. Also, your productivity and performance lackens, too. You start ignoring safety codes, and in turn, you start harming others. Every company should have a zero-tolerance policy with alcohol and drugs as well, and drug test their employees frequently.
With bitchy bridezilla Becca barking orders left and right, the boys kept their comments between each other and retreated to washing down a couple tall boys of their coincidentally named beverage. When the time came, Diego, the smallest of the three brothers, was voted to hang up the heavy chandelier. They gave him a hand-me-down ladder, and away he climbed.
According to OSHA standards, ladders must be inspected before use for cracks and broken parts. The ladder must maintain a three-point contact at all times on a stable ground. The person using the ladder must always have clean shoes that do not contain grease or mud.
While Bobby was out getting some much-needed grub for them, Fred was in charge of holding the legs of the ladder so their dear brother would be safe at the top. Diego pulled the rope over the bar and began to pull up the chandelier till it was the right height.
Earl, stop flirting with my maid of honor! Stop it! Go! Separate!
Go away!
Go away! Separate! God, you're finally doing something! Higher.
Becky stood directly under, looking overhead to tell him when it was correct.
Higher, make it higher.
Diego, standing completely on top of the ladder, was starting to feel the effects of his drink of choice. He lost his sense of balance, dropped the rope, and plummeted head first, 8 feet to the ground, cracking his skull open. The chandelier crashed right down on the bride-to-be, crushing her head and piercing her body with shards of glass. This tightened the rope around Greg's neck, hanging him up to dry.
Another main problem they had during this event was improper rigging of the chandelier. What they did was known as spot rigging. Now, you need to control the lift speed as well as you have to properly balance the load. Three things you need to know are the limitations of the base, the limitations of the rope, and the actual weight of the thing you're lifting. Now, combining all these problems, such as the unqualified workers, the drinking on the job, the improper rigging, improper use of ladder, and improper tire, there was a multiple causation effect that, in the end, by stopping maybe either all of these or individual problems, could have changed the outcome completely.
Becky was a bride who wanted to be a fairy tale come true. Instead, down came the chandelier, Becky and all.
Say, live and let die.